Listen how you feel. Said how many pounds? 1.5 pounds. That's around at this 10 pounds. Okay, I have bought a cherry tree from Asta, and I planted it in the February 9. I bought it for £6. The variety's name is Stella. Sweet tasting and temptingly glossy fruit, ideal for eating fresh and for dessert. And I planted beside the polytunnel between the another tree and the Morello cherry. According to the book, this book, The Fruit Expert by the Dr. D.G. Hesseyon, the Stella cherry is the first self-fertile sweet cherry, number one choice for garden use. It's vigorous, the flavor is good, and the flesh is juicy, and a good pollinator for the fruit other cherries. Fruit may be dark red or near black, according to this picture. This is the cherry tree, variety Stella, that I bought from Asta last year, planted here. And I noticed 3-4 months ago that it had a kind of honey-like or jam marmalade-like goo at the point that you see the white stuff in the middle. And I learned that this is a bacterial canker. So I immediately cut the top. It was in a dark afternoon, so I didn't have the time really to put the camera or anything, just to take a video. It was dark, quite dark. The next morning I came and just cut it. It was the first disease I've ever seen of the tree, of my own tree. So I just cut it immediately. This was about 6 foot high. So I cut it, and now it is about 4 foot high. And I cut it, used the fungicide, I cleaned around it, to get sure that there is no of the gooey material that tree has produced gum around that bacterial canker. So I used immediately Arborex Heal and Seal on that and covered it, so getting sure that there is no chance. Also, whatever dead leaf on it and around it on the floor, they had this kind of holes, they call it bullet shot holes, and you have to remove them. I removed them immediately, burned them somewhere, so getting sure that nothing of that remains here to be transferred to other trees. So after that, as far as I can see, it was done 3 months ago. Nothing has came back, no disease, I don't see anything. So even I may have some fruits, as you see in the center, those are fruit buds, and these are also again at the center fruit buds, and I have on other ones also some fruit buds here at the center again. So everything is not lost yet. I have another set of fruit buds here at the center. So nothing is lost much, just in the central leader. And actually it may probably give the tree a better shape. Also here at the center you see some fruit buds here. So hopefully I will have some fruits on this year. But I learned that the Stella is not resistant to bacterial canker. For that I go for other varieties, especially Merton Glory cherry, and which I bought from the Keeper's Nursery. Very good and strong tree. I will go and show you another video now after justice, or in the same video. You can compare it with this one. Just look. This is beside my polytunnel. I hope that this will help it in a way, because the warmth of the and wind protection of the polytunnel may give them a little better chance of survival, if not making it more damp for them. That is a Merton Glory cherry. I had a separate video about this, but just look at the fruit buds, so many fruit buds. And this tree, this Merton Glory cherry, which I bought from Keeper's Nursery, is resistant to most of the diseases, including the bacterial canker, fruit splitting, which happened due to the irregular rain or watering, and such things. So this is a variety which is I recommend. Last year gave me fruit, this year also hopefully will give us some fruit. Last year 2014, this year 2015. And we will see how it will do compared to other varieties. And these are other varieties that I have just in front of you. You see that. I think this one is called Napoleon Bigaro or Bijaro. It's a French variety, as you see. It was just a stick when it arrived last year. I bought it from the Keeper's Nursery again. Keeper's Nursery gives good cherries. And now you see on the old wood, it has lots of fruit, but old wood is a darker brown one. And then the top one is last year's growth. And there are some leaf buds on that, which is really good, welcoming. And it will give us some leaf to do photosynthesis and provide us with fruit this year and next year's, hopefully. Sweet cherry Stella. It is the one that I made a video about. It had a canker here. I immediately cut the bit that was in central leader. I cut it and covered it with a Arbright heal and seal, and it recovered. And now it is large. It's full of fruit buds. It gives us a lot of fruits, hopefully, this spring. There is a little bit of disease in this one, but I have to do it in the spring. I will not do anything probably now. Beyond that, it looks healthy. Cherry tree, the variety is Stella cherry. I bought it from the Astor, and in the first year it didn't give me anything. Not only didn't give me anything, it developed canker. So I had to cut the central part of this tree, and I made a video about it when I did that, and I covered it with a heal and seal, Arbrex heal and seal from Bayern. I bought it for £3, usually £7 it is, from B&Q when it was on offer. And I'm really happy about the result because it had antifungal agent and also recovered and sealed during the wet time. I cut it in the time that they usually should not cut. We should not cut really. It was late November, I think I did that. I have a video about it. You can look in my playlist and find that. But now look at it. The tree is really looking healthy. The leaves are large, huge, lots of new shoots it has given. And I think that probably gives us next year some good fruit, good amount of fruit. I'm looking forward to that. The tree is not very tall. Probably it helped me actually that I cut that central bit there, because it gave more lateral. But it's on a way of accessing my polytunnel, so I will stop this from growing anywhere this way toward the north, northwest, and north, northwest. And try to encourage it to go laterally toward the camera and away from the camera and to the right of the camera. So fill up that space, that's all right, because that is a strawberry bed and the apples Jupiter and the kids orange red. And looking healthy, I'm really impressed. And yeah, we will see how it will do. I hope it will not get canker anymore. Canker almost sounds like cancer, but anyway. That's like cancer for the trees. Looking forward for a good year. Beautiful sunset. In the allotment. Beside the button. Susan, how you feel? Yeah, there was nothing on the leaf, on the trees. It looks so miserable. Yeah, the grass is coming up. It looks very beautiful. It's the loveliest time in the year, probably. And especially also after that comes the food season, and we can enjoy the labors of our, the results, the fruit of our labors. Your lawn has grown well, the way that you wanted, patchy, very rustic.
Oh, yeah, it's patchy and rustic, and it will grow, it will grow wildlife, and just to give it that rustic look.
Yeah.
So if it grows in big clumps, and that's how we want it, the hens can't pick it up, they can't scratch. But they will eat the tips, and this is fast growing grass, so the more they eat, the more it will grow.
Yeah. Let me just come forward and see a little bit further. This is beautiful, Susan. Yeah, the grass has grown really well. Yeah, we were so worried they would not grow. Look at them now. The apples. Beautiful apple blossoms. Looks like a dream, Susan.
We still haven't put that thing to meat in yet. Oh my god. You'll have to leave it somewhere. Bring it with you when you come back.
Everything is so beautiful. This is the way the cherries look, the fruitlets of cherry look in the spring. For the purpose of scale and comparison, this is my finger. They're about 5 millimeter or 6-7 millimeter. And today is the 7th of the May. This is the Stella cherry in the first day of summer, early summer. And this is the way it looks. I can say it's almost ready as if to harvest. Beautiful, that's the size of my finger you saw, and that's the size of the fruit. Okay, Susan, I'm telling you, don't eat my apples or my cherries.
Really? Don't eat your apples or your cherries?
Yes.
Right, okay. That's not what we said. We said, don't pop my cherry.
What you mean by don't pop my cherry? Is it an English term?
No, it's American.
What that mean?
It means...
when the...
I think the viewers should go and look it up.
Okay, don't pop my cherries. Yes. You have to look for it.
And there's our little amigo.
Okie doke. This is a cherry punch. Oh, what you are doing, Eve? God has told you don't eat that one. Now you listen to the snake.
No, I'm having lunch.
Eve, are you naked now? You have some fig. feet covering your face. Is it cherry covering your face? Okay. You're having a Pepsi Cola in the heaven. Garden of Eden.
This is the way to eat fruit. And to eat fruit, the way is to just pick it off the tree.
Hope you have left something for Adam.
And it's all gone.
Oh, more here for Adam. Oh.
There are rocks.
Oh, here, look. This is a lot for Adam.
Oh, yeah.
I think God wanted it for himself, huh? What do you think? Don't touch my apples. Was a gardener. What you're doing? This is a stellar cherry. You're picking them.
It is.
You're killing them. There's the babies of the tree.
We've had them. Quite a few.
Oh.
Several. On it.
Okay, there are more here.
See them everywhere. Because your eyes.
Yeah. You have a trained eye. And this is just one tree that we have.
Yeah.
And look.
We've already
more
had
here.
A lot of cherries, I think. And we're getting. Have we had a whole? Very simple.
Hmm.
I've just seen another clock.
They are really big. It's quite dry. I think the dry weather is necessary for having the cherries ripened.
No, I think so. Just thinking that. There's more. You have to get right into the tree, but I've seen them out there.
Oh, look, they're big.
No, they're hiding under the plants.
Try not to destroy the fruit system. That's the important part.
Yeah.
They're just under your elbow, here.
Oh,
yeah, pick them. Oh, you had eaten already one of them and just you chucked on it. Because you know why?
Yeah, it's like juicy.
Because you were eating without telling me.
And the juice just went straight down my throat. And
you
now
promised you will share good and bad with me. And you were just sharing the bad with me, having the good for yourself. One fell. So, how many hundreds of pounds we are saving by having our own tree? What do you think?
Well, I don't really know.
We have around 12 cherry trees. You know that.
Yeah.
So, you know that you have to come every day and collect a lot.
The producers must make money.
And this is the Stella cherry which was dying in the first year. I bought it from Asta, but it was dying and I saved it from canker.
Tiny, wasn't it?
Yeah. Yeah, that's the place that it had canker. It grew. I used the Arbrex.
Yeah.
I used the Arbrex, it was on a discount from the B&Q. And we saved it by that. Darling. You know that there is another punnet under that punnet.
Okay, that's from full punnet.
No, 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 we have no space there. Look, these branches are going everywhere. Oh, here. Oh, everywhere. This one tree we were just harvesting at the moment, and it had that amount.
We've had another half of them here. This is the second one.
Let me go to this. Oh, you got more. Okay, here.
I think we need to take it up.
Yeah, there is another one under it.
Yeah, look, there's more down there.
Yeah, under, under. Yeah.
Okay.
Put this here until we come back.
There's more up there, look.
Okay,
the
I'm going.
You'll have to take them, can you see?
Should we harvest all at once? Or should we leave it for every day, coming a little bit harvest?
Well, if they're ripe, I'll take them. And make it on the tree, they'll...
They may shrivel, do they?
They'll just die, won't they? Just go rotten. You need to eat them, they're ready to eat.
Yeah. God, they're so beautiful. I must say. That's one of the most beautiful.
This one there that you show you.
Yeah, oh look, here, on top.
Yes, I saw that. There's more on top.
Let's hold it.
There you
are. I'm going.
If I pull the branch down, you can just see.
Which one? I can see, Susan.
No,
I don't need.
Side.
I can see.
Just above my head.
Above your head? Oh, here. Yeah. Two.
Oh, yeah, okay.
The more here. And I can easily pick them.
Yeah.
There is a lot on top of also, but.
We'll have to put something behind
us. Yeah, that's the reason I was cutting them, just
to
control. Yeah, fruit collection.
Yes.
Fruit collecting things. Oh yeah, I think there is a few just on really high ground, high branches. Yeah. Look. Oh, don't put the moldy ones. Let the chickens eat them. There is the rest. Just 1 minute of when you harvested that punnet of cherry, you earn £5 now. 5 pounds of cherry. Oh, this is a stellar cherry. That was the one which had canker, and I cured it, I think. Let me taste one of these.
Then we're going through the other ones, Morello.
Morello cherry, yeah.
Yeah, we have to cook them and make coffee.
Yes, yeah, Susan, look here, on top.
But these are coming in my lunch.
Take the ones which are red, don't take the other ones, because they come in succession.
These ones?
No, no. Don't take the ones which are not red completely.
Well, this one's red.
Yeah, take the ones only which are red.
Because
they will come later, and you will have more.
All red.
Yeah. Look forward.
There are some
round
here.
Let me taste one. You are eating a lot.
Oh, yeah.
And we have harvested how many punnets? 1.5 punnet. That's around at this £10 value wise.
In England, they're very expensive. Okay.
Yeah, they have to import it from. I mean, there was. Before the war, and a little bit after the war, I mean Second World War, there was a lot of orchards of cherry, because it grows very well here. Then they uprooted them for other things, and buildings, towns and other things. So now we have to import them from Spain, California, as far as Chile, or yeah, those areas. California is really far, the other side of the earth. So we can grow it here now, you can see.
It does take a long time for cherry trees.
Yeah, it's just 4 years we had to wait.
But
last year we gave a few. This year we really gave a good one.
It's a long time.
Yeah.
It's all right doing it yourself.
And yet even now I'm finding more.
Oh, nice.
I thought it's finished. Yeah, take them.
And I've seen some more here.
Eve, can I pop a cherry? Your cherry. YouTube will not let pop a cherry, so we have to censor that. I don't know why they are against their wife and husband pop a cherry.
Well, we thought popping a cherry was just taking the kick out. So.
Yeah, but it's another meaning, I think in
it's
America.
An American meaning, isn't it?
Yeah.
But
anyway, we picked a lot of cherries, we can pop it later. Drink of water in this hot weather, and I was looking at the beautiful harvest of cherries that we have. And this is just from one Estella and three branches of the merchant. And that's a good result.
That's
so we have around I think 11 more trees to go.
We have
cherries. And as you can see here, we have even three more Morello cherries. These are sweet cherries, of course. We go and enjoy them. Yeah, let's go. One egg also.
Yes, that's my little friend Amigo. My little Benji, this one that follows me around.
Keep it in the cool bag.
Yeah. This one's faster. This is why I prefer the ones with lids. Mm-hmm. You can stack them very much easier.
Yeah, you can stack them.
I put them like this crisscross.
Yeah, that's better.
And then they won't,
Yeah. It's dark now, but this is the harvest. This is the Stella cherry. Morella cherry few, it was so dark we couldn't see them. This is two punnets of the red currant. We picked from one side of the plant, just not all of them even. Just bigger bunches. There is more than that. And for just half an hour, we came here. None of these trees were watered for a long time. Since the last time we had rain, 1 month ago probably. And that's it. Suzanne, are you happy with this?
It just took me a few minutes.
Yeah, how much do you think that this cost us?
Oh my goodness.
The punnet of the cherry, £2.
I think for this...
This is three punnets of the cherries that you buy in the shop. This is another three, six. So that is already £12. This is if it two punnets.
Those are very expensive,
yeah.
Aren't they?
So this is also, we can say, £10. £22 of fruit.
Probably about £20 of fruit. Because
yeah.
This is the best fruit, and it's...
Yeah, it's select and they're ripe.
You just buy a few little, about 12 little cherries in this.
Oh yeah, 12 little cherries, yeah.
And you just
so
get
true.
Tiny little
packets. They say it is coming from California or Spain or somewhere.
Yeah, they do.
We grow it in Britain.
But they're not so difficult to grow in Britain.
No, they definitely can grow. You need just a little care and establishing them on the first years. Then after that they start to get...
And peaches grow. Kiwi fruits grow.
Yeah.
So there's quite a few grapes grow, which is getting popular now.
Yeah, beautiful. Let me see, where is the moon? Ooh. It's the moon, it's the moon. It's too bright now. This is cherry morello in the November, mid-November. And as you can see, the leaves are going gradually yellow, red, orange, different colors. Almost all the cherries are going through this now. Beautiful autumn display. I must admit, I never noticed the change of color in the cherries so much pronounced. They are really amazing at this time of the year. Is it exceptional this year is like that? I think last year by then all the leaves were finished. And here we are in the mid-November and we have yet these beautiful leaves.